Hi there! In this tutorial, you will learn how to use sprites in your TextMesh Pro text boxes. It is probably much easier than you'd think. First, of course, we will need a few sprites to work with. I have created a super basic sprite sheet like this, just three flowers in a row. I import it into Unity, set its sprite mode to multiple, and slice it into three sprites of equal size. Apply your changes. An important step here is to reset your pivot points. Let's say in the final text box, you want your sprite to show up like this. Well, if you keep your pivot point in the center of the graphic, it will actually be set to this position. So, you'll need to figure out where your pivot point needs to be set to. Every sprite you have will be treated like a letter. Thus, your pivot's X value should be the leftmost side of your sprite, or rightmost if your writing system works like that. And its Y value should correspond to where your text's baseline is. You'll need to reset every sprite's pivot point, so if you have many of different shapes, this might take a moment. My three are roughly the same position, so I'll just set the pivot point to bottom left. You can tweak later, of course, but having a solid base will make your life easier. Apply your changes. With this done, right-click on your sprite sheet and go to Create, TextMesh Pro, Sprite Asset. A new asset will be created and you should rename it to something you can recognize. You will need to move this asset to the folder specified in the TextMesh Pro settings here, or you can assign a new folder in the same spot, but I tend to just leave it as it is. While we are here, we can set our newly created sprite asset as a default one too. This will save us a lot of time. If we don't do this, we need to set it up for each and every single text box we have. Alright, let's have a closer look at our newly created asset. Under Sprite Sheet Character Table, you'll see a list of all the sprites in your asset. The most important bit is the name. You can reset it to something that makes more sense, but you'll have to keep in mind that you can only use every name once. You can call every sprite either by their index number or by their name, and personally, I prefer using the name. I'll explain the sprite glyph table in a moment, but first let's actually use our new powers. In this text field, I want to add a small sprite right behind the name of the flower to make it easier recognizable what my NPC wants. Let's add sprite name chamomile here. It already pops up. Since it works like a letter, I'll need to add an empty space before it, or it will be stuck to the last letter of the previous word. Let's give the other sprites a try too. I feel like I want to tweak their placement a little bit. The purple flower looks good, but the chamomile feels a bit too high, while the poppy could be set a tiny bit lower also. This is when we have a look into this sprite glyph table. We can't change the pivots now anymore, or else we would have to create a new asset. But here, we can tweak the values too. I wouldn't change any of the ones up here. These values are straight from the sprite sheet and should be correct. But those three look promising. Bx moves the sprite on its x-axis, By on y, and ad gives it a little bit more spacing to the right of it. If the scale isn't right either, we can slightly tweak its value here. If you are sure you won't need a sprite, you can delete it here. If you want to add sprites though, you are out of luck, so treat carefully. You can duplicate them and give them other names, so you can have variations if you need them, but otherwise you'll need to create a new sprite asset. Well, at this point you're basically already done. But this tutorial wouldn't be complete without a trick with style sheets. Let's say you're not only using these sprites once, but they pop up more often. Maybe as a small icon of items or tiny portraits of your game's characters, so you'll need to reuse them often. Here, I am already using a style for each kind of flower. You can watch this video up here to see how it works. Behind the style tag is a tag for the flower to use. Well, you can hop over into the style sheet and add the sprite you'll need too. But this time, we'll add it to the closing tags, because we want the sprite to pop up behind the word we tagged with the style. You could, of course, add it to the opening tag too if you'd like. It works just the same. Just make sure to add it as the last tag in your list. Now, this will save us a lot of time whenever we need to use a word and sprite combination anywhere. Last tip, if you need or want to work with multiple sprite assets, you can manually set the ones you'll need down here. I'd still suggest only using a single asset though, since juggling multiples will become hard to track at some point. I hope this tutorial was helpful to you. If it was, please consider liking and subscribing. See you in the next video!